In a previous tutorial video, we talked about the difference between strokes and fills. And we also mentioned that strokes are good for basic things, but if you intend to have your drawn object in any other medium, let's say you're designing a logo and you want it to be on products that are both big and small, you want it to be able to be small for a business card or even large for a billboard, then strokes aren't the best way to go. And the reason why is because they don't resize in proportion or proportionally with the rest of the object. So let's see what this looks like. If I highlight my pretend logo here, and if I start increasing the stroke, you can see that it starts eating away at the green triangles that I have in the logo. And that's not how I wanted it to look. And that's basically what happens when you try to resize it. So let's go back down to a 3-point stroke. And I'm going to copy two of these, and we're going to see what happens when you make it bigger and what happens when you make it smaller. So I'll hold Alt to copy. And this first one right here, let's say I want it to be on a business card. So I'm going to make it really small because business cards are pretty tiny. And as I make it small, you can see that in proportion, now all of a sudden the stroke is becoming a lot more prominent than it was in this version of the logo. So if I go even smaller, which sometimes you might have to, it really starts to look like it's eating away at it. This is not something I want for my business card. In addition, if I were to grab that same logo and make it bigger, and you kind of don't see it as much as you would see it if we were designing this for a billboard, but you can see how now all of a sudden in proportion, the stroke is a lot smaller to the fill compared to this one. And people get pretty picky about their logo, so this is not a good idea. So instead of using strokes, we use something called offset path, which pretty much takes an object or objects, and what it will do is it'll make a copy of that object behind the original objects and expand it out a certain size. So let's go ahead and see how to do this. I'm going to first draw my object again, but this time I'm going to choose no stroke. And I'm going to grab my polygon tool, which is how I made this triangle. Hold shift. And kind of get it the way I want it. And from here, I'm just going to copy this by holding the Alt key and dragging 4 different times. And when I go to transform it or rotate it, if I hold shift, I can make sure that it's moving at 45 degree angles. 45, 40, whatever. And let's kind of get it where we need it to go. And then finally we have this one. And again, holding shift will ensure that it's pretty straight. Okay, so that may or may not be perfect, but it's what we got with the time we have. So I'll grab my objects and I'll go up to Object, Path, Offset Path. So it's gonna have a preview option and you wanna do that. And it's showing you the different lines. So the inside triangles are the ones I just drew, and the outside triangles are those extra triangles that it's going to draw behind those that have an offset path. So they've been expanded 7 points. So if I come here and I say, let's say 3, the offset path isn't a lot. And let's say I do 33, and it's quite a bit. So let's go down to 7 because I think that's a pretty good offset path for me. And you can change what joins you use. And if we go to round, you can see that we have a rounded edge around them. You can do bevel, and that kind of has a flat top. But we're just going to use regular miter. And let's go ahead and click OK. And it looks like nothing really happened except for expanded a little bit. Well, that's just because the offset path version is the same color as the triangle we originally created. So if I click that back triangle and turn it black, that's kind of what's happening there. So I can shift click all those back triangles and change those all to black. And there we go. The only difference is I obviously don't want my green triangles to be cut off in some of these areas. So I'll shift click each of those, right click, arrange, bring to front. So there we go. There's my object. It kind of looks exactly the same as it did when I drew it with strokes. However, now it's going to be the opposite of what you see here. As it gets bigger, my stroke should get bigger, and as it gets smaller, my stroke should get smaller. And that's what the offset path is going to do. So I'm going to first group this object. So go to Object, Group. That's not necessary, but I find it to be a really good thing to do because I want these all to be a part of each other. So now this is looking pretty good. Kind of the same as this one, a little bit too big still. But now if I alt copy one for the business card and one for the billboard, so this one's going to be a lot smaller. And as you can see, in proportion, the stroke is not as big as what we were seeing over here, and this one's even smaller because it's proportionally resizing the fill and the offset path, which is what our stroke is. And as I make this bigger, this one's going to have a much more prominent offset path or stroke. We're going to see it better because, again, we're seeing this from far away as we're driving down the highway on a billboard. And so it has to be bigger so that we can see it. So this is the correct way of doing that. Now, if you're just designing this, you know you're doing a flyer and you're never going to put this on anything else, go ahead and use strokes because it really didn't take a lot of time to do strokes. And it takes a little bit more effort to do an offset path. But if you know it's something that's going to be used over and over again, and you don't know what size it's going to be used at, then you definitely need to be using that offset path. In addition, when you're doing something for a printer, they probably don't want you to use strokes as well. They might need to have this offset path, and that's what they would use to create, let's say, a cut line so they can cut it out and perhaps make this a sticker.